sent it from heaven. You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down. Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers. So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven.
Yes, give it to me. How you doing, YouTube? This is Corey P, aka Cores, aka Mr. Fantastic. And that was an old, like, it ain't even old school, that's just old girl. That was Miss Billie Holiday, Pennies from Heaven. I played that for Alex because she's a Billie Holiday fan. And yeah, that was for you, girl. Pennies from Heaven. Anyway, so today's topic, it's Tuesday, now it's Wednesday morning at 7:54. That's right, just got off that work, headed home, I'm here, took a shower, oh, I feel good, I'm so fresh and so clean, you know, washed my booty, everything, so I'm clean, I'm great. Yeah, but girl, I want to talk about this tea. I had to clock this tea. So, I guess we're just going to get right into it. So, yesterday, a sidebar, you know, this is just a, you know, note, like, so I decided to pump it to the subway, which is right up the way from my house. It's literally, like, right up there, like, up the street and around the corner. And, you know, I go there to get some food, and I happen to be acquainted with one of the guys that works there. He's younger. He's an Indian fellow. He's really cool. He's nice. I think he has a little thing for me. He's not bad to look at. He's actually kind of easy on the eyes, and he's nice. And so every now and then he hooks me up. You know, he gives me some food. Sidebar, by the way, if you getting free shit, you know. Because, you know, I don't always get free shit, but when I do, I just love it. It pays to be cute, I don't know. But when you get in free shit, girl, don't fuck your hookup up. That's number one. Don't ever fuck your hookup up. Don't do so trifling shit. Like, don't always expect this person to get you something free. Like, you know, every now and then, you got to come in and do your part and pay. Because, you know, every now and then, you know, I pay when I have money. But, you know, as we heard from my last couple of posts, how I had to pay rent, and how I was gypped from my dad, who wants to be Cokehead of the Year. So, you know, with that, I kind of, you know, had no money for groceries. And, you know, he proposed this to me a long time ago. He was like, you know, if you ever just need something to eat, like if you, you know, because I think I was on the phone with my mom, and I was like, yeah, I need some money for groceries. It was like way back when I first moved here, and I first met him, and he was just kind of like, you know, if you need something to eat, just come by and I'll fix you something. Like, it's not a big deal. Like, you know, it's just, it's probably, you know, most of this stuff we throw out at the end of the day anyway. So, you know, so I was like, okay, every now and then I'll take you up on the offer. So this past week I've been running to, like, taking him up on the offer, girl. Like I said, it pays to be cute. And also with that said, when you're getting hooked up, you know, you can't give them too much. You know, like, I give this person, you gotta give them time. Like, you can't just expect some free shit and don't get nothing in return. But, you know, don't give him everything. Me, I give him conversation, a smile, and, you know, some light flirting every now and then. But, you know, that's, hey, I mean, hey, I got some free food. I'm fed, so, I mean, I feel like a whore, but I'm not. I mean, you know, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. So, but anyway, so this particular day, yeah, I was in there, and, you know, I think it was like, yeah, it's yesterday. I'm sorry, I was talking like it's weeks ago. It's yesterday. So I was in there, and, you know, just, I got my little sandwich, my little turkey. And that's another thing, people, like, when you getting hooked up. I mean, unless they just put it out there that you get anything you want. Like, I try to get, you know, I try to compromise. Like, you know, when it's free food, like, I'm not going to get the whole shabam. Like, you know, Subway has whole pizzas now. You know, I'm not going to be like, yeah, let me get two of them whole pizzas. No, I'm going to get something. You know, let me get a turkey sandwich, you know, some mayo, some lettuce, some, you know, some banana pepper, some cheese. You know, I'm not trying to get the 404 on, you know, because, you know, this person's going out on a limb for me. And, you know, you don't want to do that. And, you know, definitely, like, I don't let people fuck up my hookups. Like, I don't come in with 4 and 5 of my friends. I was like, oh, yeah, girl, he'll hook you on up. Mm-mm. That, once again, that's how you fuck up a hookup. So, yeah. But anyway, so like I said, I was there. I was eating my little turkey sandwich. And in the back, it was these group of little Indian guys. It was like 3 of them and a girl. An Indian girl. And it's clear that 3 Indian guys were gay. Like, you know, I don't know if they, you know, I don't know too much about East Indian culture. But I know some of them do that arranged marriage situation. So I don't know how that works with them and them being gay, but, you know, it's clear that these kids were the kids, honey. They were the girls. So, you know, one of them was really cute. One of them was, and then you had the beast. Oh, my God, girl. And as it always is, why is the beast the one that just thinks that they are just the shit, girl? Like, and I mean, like, and I've come across some beasts. At least the other beasts I've come across, you know, they actually dress the part. You know, they might actually try to do something with the mug that they've been given. You know, some makeup, a light shave here and there, something. You know, a cute haircut, something to take the focus away from the ugly. You know, this beast was a beast. Like, just a straight beast, like from X-Men Beast. Like, girl, all he needed was the blue fur and the powers, girl. He just needed to jump from one end of the room to the next, girl. It's like, ooh, girl, it's about 5 o'clock. Shouldn't you be in the danger room with the rest of the X-Men, girl? Because you, okay, girl, you look quite beastly. But anyway, so yeah, they were sitting in the corner. Like, it's like a little narrow spot to get to the bathroom. So they were sitting in the table right in front of the bathroom. And so the beast was kind of blocking the bathroom. So anyway, I was walking. And instantly, I guess one of the two not so bad looking ones kind of looked my way and was like, oh, you know, I think he's coming this way. So the beast was just automatically like looking like, why is he coming this way? Oh my God, LLL. Like, he just had, he was giving the stank, like, bitchy queenie face. And I was like, okay. So anyway, I had to pee because I also got a big gulp of, you know, he gave me one of the big cups to fill up my, that's not the Subway will hook you up on a drink. Like, even if you're paying for it, like, you get the big cup, girl. But anyway, so I had to pee. So I was, you know, walking. And so, like, I was like, excuse me, you know, and I was about to say, excuse me, can I get by you? Hold on. That's mommy. I'll call her back later. So anyway, I was about to say, excuse me, you know, let me get by you. I just need to, but before I could get all that out, he was just instantly like, like, you know, he was like, oh no, you know, I don't want to talk to you. You're not my type. I don't even like black guys. Ill, you know, like, whoa, like, you know, why did you even think you had a chance? And like, you know, like, I'm just sitting here like this face, like, okay, well, right, yeah, what I was gonna say before you cut me off, girl, was that you're blocking the bathroom and I kinda have to go. Yeah, so could you move out the way? And so, like, instantly his friends were kinda like, ooh, girl, you just went off on him for no reason. So, you know, he's looking stupid, so I get to the bathroom and I get to call also. So, you know, and, like, it's a tight space, and they're right by the bathroom. So, I guess they heard me going in. It was, I think it was my friend in Texas who I was talking to. Because I was just going in on him, girl. I was talking about him from his head to his toe. Because that was just uncalled for. Like, first of all, like, okay, you don't like black men. Girl, we don't like you. Like, who told you was a hot commodity, honey? Like, I just, honestly, like, I can honestly say that, you know, I don't know too many other gay black men, but I'm pretty sure, like, they ain't looking at you like, ooh, girl, what's the tea? I want to get with that. Mm-mm. They probably looking like, ooh, mm-mm. I mean, girl, you look like the gay version of the Simpsons character who works at the Quickie Mart. Like, you know, like, you have, like, this horrible haircut with your balding. You know, girl, like, how are you supposed to be, like, in your early 20s and you look like you about 50 in the face and the body? Like, you know, like, you have this face full of acne. You look oily. Like, your face is like one of those Tostinos, like, pepperoni pizzas. Girl, you know, the little speckled pepperoni. And, you know, you just look greasy and cheesy in the face. And, you know, you got the nerves to talk about some ill, look at your face. And then, girl, your breath. Oof. Smelled like doo-doo water. Girl, are you serious? Like, what made you think that I was even trying to holler at you? Now, I would probably, if I was just really about it, I would have tried to holler at your friends over there. And girl, the reason why they keep you around is to elevate their looks, girl. Because, like, you know, you're not, I mean, they're not the finest things walking either, but they look decent compared to you. And I guess next to you, they look like some fine motherfuckers, which they kind of did. Like, they did. They look really good compared to you. So, and then, girl, you got this horrible body. Like, you got these saddlebags. You're wearing these duck head docker khaki shorts that fit you very ill. You have, like, this hanging gut. Girl, stop yourself. Really. Like, girl, stop it. Like, you're giving yourself too much credit here. Like, did you really think that inside your little mind that I was actually trying to holler at you, girl? Like, you know, you know, like, And I mean, I don't, you know, and then how you gonna sit and talk to you don't like black folk? Like, you, okay, girl, that's fine. But, you know, you just as dark as me, girl, just because your hair is straight and jet black, girl. You know, yes, I'm the black nigga, but you the sand nigga, girl. Like, come on. They don't like you either. So, you know, in the big scheme of things, they label you as a terrorist, girl. So, you know, what is up with all this fever that you're giving me right now? You know, breast smelling like curry and shit. Girl, gone somewhere. Like, I went off on him, girl. Like, that's, I was saying that and more, girl. Like, I went in on him and came out the bathroom and my friend... And the count, I was like, I think you offended them because, like, they kind of heard you in the bathroom over there. And old dude was apparently very upset. And I was like, oh, well, I mean, that's what he gets for trying to make this scene, this spectacle of himself trying to go in on me. So, yeah. With that said, girl, like, a lot of times you really shouldn't just assume. You know what they say about assuming? You make an ass out of you and me. So you shouldn't assume that I was trying to holler at you and then proceeded to go in on me. Even if you thought that, you should just be like, oh, no, thank you or something. But no, you proceed to go in. So therefore, I had to go in and you got your feelings hurt. Oh, well. So, yeah, that's my rant for the day. And I'm about to go to bed. Good night.